though, first with breaking news, we're talking about those deadly storms that are on the move right now. Violent thunderstorms, they've been slamming into eastern Tennessee, happened overnight. Reportedly, two people are dead. Dozens of other people have been injured. Let's get right to Rob Marciano. He's in our Extreme Weather Center with an update. Hey, Rob.
Good morning, Soledad. This is an area that is highly populated during the summer months. A lot of tourism in here, great Smoky Mountain National Park, and this storm tore right through the area across the front country. So you can imagine, RVs, tents, they don't do a whole lot of good when talking about big trees that are falling down, because this complex of storms rolled through Knoxville, Tennessee Valley, and just to the west of the Appalachians, and kind of converged over this area right along the park. Winds gusting at times 70 miles an hour. That took multiple trees down, dozens injured. As you mentioned, two fatalities, and there's still some folks that are hurt there that they're trying to get at them. Right now, it's all quiet. Sun goes down. We lose the heat. We lose a lot of the energy. But later on today, that heat will build back up, and especially along this front, which will eventually save the East Coast as far as the heat is concerned. That's where we expect most of the severe weather. South of that, more heat, more humidity. Two dozen states under heat advisories and warnings today. Dangerous heat, another record-setting day for places like St. Louis, Chicago, maybe even Pittsburgh. Places like that are going to see 100-degree-plus temperatures. 91, that's pretty toasty in New York. 100 again in D.C. We will cool down Sunday, Monday. But until then, a lot of red on the map. 91 degrees in New Orleans. That's cool, relatively speaking, although it's kind of humid. Soledad, back to you.
Nathan Harmony and I was in the
All right, Rob.